मॉर्निंग फ्रेंड्स, एज वी हैव डिस्कस अबाउट द थर्मल इंटरेक्शन, डायरेक्टिविटी इंटरेक्शन, नाउ वी हैव टू टॉक अबाउट जनरल इंटरेक्शन ऑफ द टू सिस्टम विच इज आइसोलेटेड फ्रॉम इट्स सराउंडिंग मेम्ब्रेन्स ऑफ द वॉल. हीट, ए फॉर्म ऑफ एनर्जी विच कम्स थ्रू द वॉल्स इन टू द सिस्टम, इंक्रीजेज द इंटरनल एनर्जी ऑफ द सिस्टम. और से एनर्जी विच गोज आउट फ्रॉम द सिस्टम थ्रू द वॉल्स डिक्रीज द इंटरनल एनर्जी ऑफ द सिस्टम. विद इन द सिस्टम द चेंज ऑफ द प्रेशर एंड टेम्परेचर एंड इन्स वर्क डन ऑन आर बाय द सिस्टम. वी कैन से जनरल इंटरेक्शन इन्वॉल्व बोथ द ट्रांसफर ऑफ द एनर्जी एंड डूइंग द वर्क. ए थर्मोडायनामिक सिस्टम कैन डू वर्क ऑन इट्स सराउंडिंग लूजिंग सम ऑफ इट्स हीट. सिमिलरली वर्क डन वर्क कैन बी डन ऑन अ सिस्टम एक्सटर्नली एंड एज अ रिजल्ट द हीट कंटेंट ऑफ द सिस्टम वुड इंक्रीज. दस देयर आर टू मेन एवेन्यूज ऑफ हीट एक्सचेंज फॉर थर्मोडायनामिक सिस्टम, विच मीन्स इट्स इंटरनल एनर्जी ऑफ सिस्टम चेंजेस. द नेट चेंज ऑफ इंटरनल एनर्जी यू एफ माइनस यू is delta U can be written as UF minus UI is equal to minus W. Q is the amount of the heat absorbed. Q is amount of the heat absorbed by the system. W is amount of the work done by the system. Then the first law says that all transformation of the thermal system for a given initial state A and to the given both Q and W measured and the difference is Q minus W. You know what is that? The delta U is equal to Q minus W. That is the internal. The thermal system is capable of interacting with surrounding in two distance ways, mechanically, that is by doing or absorbing work, and thermally, that is by giving out or taking heat in the amount of the work by the system. In such a cases, depend only on the initial state and the final state of the system, not on the intermediate state through which it can pass. Further, the amount of work does not depend on whether that's why the internal energy is path independent. Okay, work is path function, path dependent, whereas the internal energy is not. It is a state function. The thermodynamic process changes the state of the system. Finally, one can rewrite the first law of the independent one. dq is equal to du plus dw. Okay, dw is equal to p delta v. dq is equal to, the internal system is made up of many components, any or all of which may increase when you add heat to the system or do work on it. If the system is a gas, for example, the internal includes the translation, the vibration, rotational kinetics, energy of the molecules. Okay, the internal energy is a function of state. It is a state function, I said. Okay, it is not the path function. Work is a path function. Then this particularly gas whose state is determined by its pressure, volume and temperature, that the internal energy is uniquely determined by the PVT, that is by the state of the gas. It also means that the system is going from one state to another, and the change in the internal energy is route independent, means path independent. Internal energy can be changed by performance or work by the addition of the change in internal energy, or by addition of the heat, or some combination of each. But whatever combination of work and energy is added, the change in internal depends only upon the initial and the final state. This means mathematically internal energy is exact differential that you have to, that may come for the MCQ. Heat depend, path dependence of the heat. Internal energy of system constant composition can be changed by work or heat interaction with its surrounding. Both these energy transfer processes are path independent. However, the internal energy is a function only of the state of the system. The first law of thermodynamics connects this quantity is delta U is equal to Q minus W. The delta indicates U is a state function. This means that the change in internal depends only on the variables of the state TV, etc., and not on the path taken from one state to another. Heat and work, on the other hand, do depend on the path taken. If the system considered is adiabatic so that no heat transfer occurs, Q is equal to W. This expression shows that the adiabatic work done is taking in a system. Path, heat and work is a path dependent that you have. Application of first law of thermodynamics, perfect system, perfect gas. What is the first law of thermodynamics? You know, the total energy is conserved, that you have to remember. It is nothing but a law of conservation of energy. In specific heat of ideal gas, that specific heat gives us an idea about amount of energy or say heat we need to provide to a system in order to bring about a unit rise in temperature of the system. Its value may vary depending on the process you are providing this energy. Hence, we have two values C, namely Cp and Cv. The specific heat capacity of a substance is quantity of heat required to raise the temperature of unit mass of substance by 1 degree. That may come for the MCQ. Molar heat capacity at constant volume, molar heat capacity at constant pressure. This definition is same, is the quantity of heat required to raise the temperature of 1 mole of gas by 1 Kelvin if the volume of the gas remains constant. And it is the quantity of the heat required to raise the temperature 1 mole of the gas by 1 Kelvin if the pressure of the gas remains constant. If the heat is added a constant volume, we have simplified. So the equation du is equal to dq is equal to cv dt. Cv is equal to dq by dt at v. If an instrumentation will dq, cp is equal to dq by dt at p. Okay, that you have to remember.